الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way He deserves to be praised. And we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace and send His blessings and salutations upon a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters, we are at a very critical chapter or topic in the book of Al-Aqeedatul-Waasitiyyah, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. And we're going to have a deep dive into understanding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names and attributes via the information that we receive from His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So we have the Shaykh saying, قَوْلُهُ وَبِمَا وَصَفَهُ بِهِ رَسُولُهُ, meaning we believe in what Allah Azza wa Jal described Himself with, and we believed in what Allah, what His Messenger described Him with, and what His Messenger described Him with. وَوَصَفَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَوَصْفُ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمِ لِرَبِّهِ يَنْقَصِمُ إِلَى ثَلَاثَةِ أَقْسَامِ. The description that the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ gave to Allah is divided into three sections or categories. إِمَّا بِالْقَوْلِ أَوْ بِالْفِعْلِ أَوْ بِالْإِقْرَارِ, either by a statement, something the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أو بالفعل, or by action, أو بالإقرار, is by approval, or by approval. أما القول فكثير, as for examples of statements, we have abundance. مثل ربنا الله الذي في السماء تقدس اسمك أمرك في السماء والأرض, such as Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, our Lord, Allah who is above the heavens, hallowed be your name, your command and your order permeates in the heavens and in the earth. وقوله في يمينه ولا لا ومقلب القلوب, or the Prophet ﷺ saying when making an oath, no, by the one who turns the hearts. Now of course you see the correlation between the previous dua and what the Christians say, right? You guys are familiar with the Christians, you know, our Father, hallowed be your name. They have a similar dua, and that shows you the connection between the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and between Jesus, and that the prophets came with similar teachings and similar messages in terms of their relationship with Allah and the words that they would use to worship Allah. But it is people that changed the religion, and the Jews successfully changed Judaism. The Christians successfully changed the teachings of Jesus and therefore Christianity. And there are many Muslims today that work day and night to change Islam, as mind-boggling as it may sound and as hurtful as it may sound. There are Muslims today that work day and night to change Islam, to make it more modernized, more agreeable, more according to them civilized, less barbaric, more and more. A lot of changes are being made, but if we follow the footsteps of the Jews and the Christians, then you will wind up somewhere else. However, Allah Azza wa Jal promised us their religion will be preserved, so their efforts will be in vain. Only those whom Allah had intended for them to be misguided will follow those people. Naam. وَأَمَّا الْفِعْلِ, as for the action, فَهُوَ أَقَلُّ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ, it is less than the statements. مِثْلُ إِشَارَتِهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ يَسْتَشْهِدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ إِقْرَارِ أُمَّتِهِ بِالْبَلَغِ, such as the Prophet ﷺ pointing his finger to the sky, making Allah bear witness that his nation acknowledged his conveyance of the message. وَهَذَا فِي حُجَّةِ الْوَدَعِ في عرفة حجة الوداع, نعم, and that was in the farewell pilgrimage in عرفة. خطب الناس, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم admonished the people, وقال ألا هل بلغت, have I not conveyed, he said to them, have I not conveyed, قالوا نعم, they said yes, ثلاث مرات, three times. قال اللهم اشهد, يَرْفَعُ إِصْبَعَهُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وَيَنْكُتُهَا إِلَى النَّاسِ. The Prophet ﷺ then raised his finger to the sky, said, "Oh Allah, bear witness," and then he pointed at the people. And this is from the actions of the Prophet ﷺ, and the hadith is in Sahih Muslim, that the Prophet ﷺ pointed to the heavens. So any funny bunny who wants to come today and say, "Akhi, Akhi, Ya Sheikh, how dare you say Allah is above? How dare you say Allah is not everywhere? How dare you restrict Allah to a location? And Allah is the creator of locations. And how dare you?" I say, don't, calm down, buddy. You're not better than the Messenger of Allah. And I'm not better than the Messenger of Allah. And what do you think the Messenger of Allah was referring to when he said, "Oh Allah, bear witness"? What does that mean? That the Prophet ﷺ believed Allah is above the heavens, Ya Shaykh. Ya Shaykh, that's what you're supposed to believe. If you have been taught by the Ash'ari school a belief system that is contrary to that of your messenger, and then you select the Ash'ari school over your messenger, and you want to be with the Prophet ﷺ around his lake in the Jannah, يعني كيف يعني؟ يعني كيف؟ You willingly come across these narrations that are explicit from your messenger, and then you select some other human being who came 200-300 years after because of some exposure to Greek philosophy, came up with the idea that we cannot describe Allah certain ways and that this is anthropomorphism and blah, 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 blah. And they formulated a new belief that the Sahaba were not familiar with. And you want to be with the Messenger of Allah on the last day? يعني عجيب أمرك يا رجل وأن لك ذلك إلا أن يشاء الله. We say the Messenger of Allah did it, then we do it. فرفع إصبعه إلى السماء هذا وصف الله تعالى بالعلو عن طريق الفعل. So Prophet ﷺ raises finger to the sky, to the heavens, and this is the Messenger of Allah. This is the description of Allah in regards to His transcendence through actions. وغير ذلك وجاء رجل عفوا وهو يخطب الناس يوم الجمعة. Another man came to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم while he was given khutbah on the day of Jumu'ah. قال يا رسول الله. He said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, هلكت الأموال. Our wealth has perished." فرفع يديه. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم raised his hands. وهذا أيضا وصف لله بالعلو عن طريق الفعل. This is again a description of Allah's transcendence through action. Because if Allah was everywhere, ya akhwan, then the Messenger of Allah should have gone like this. Oh Allah, bring down rain upon us. He wouldn't go like this. Why would you raise your hands to the sky if Allah was everywhere? يعني يا جماعة والله أمركم غريب. And we have today people that want to tell you, it's okay whether you believe this one or you believe that one. Alhamdulillah, ma fi mushkila. As long as you're happy and satisfied, yeah, you're good to go, brother. Barakallah feek. Wa feeka barakallah. Where are you from, Al-Imam Ahmad? Rahimahullah. Hey. Wa ghayru dhalika min al-ahadith lati fiha fi'lu an-nabiy alayhi salatu wassalam idha dhakara sifatan min sifatillah. And other narrations we have wherein we have the action of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam if he mentions one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ahyanan yadhkuru ar-rasul alaihi salatu wasalam as-sifa min sifatillah bil-qawli wa yu'akkiduha bil-fi'l. There are occasions where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would mention an attribute of Allah verbally, and he will affirm it with actions. وَذَلِكَ حِينَمَا تَلَى قَوْلَهُ تَعَالَى. Such as when the Prophet ﷺ recited the statement of Allah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Verily, Allah is ever all-hearer, all-seer. فَوَضَعَ إِبْهَامَهُ عَلَى أُذُنِهِ الْيُمْنَى. So the Prophet ﷺ put his index finger on his eye. فوضع إبهامه على أذن يمنى والتي تليه على عينه. And the one after on his eye. Sorry, it's like this. وهذا إثبات. Wait, the Prophet ﷺ, he put his thumb on his right ear, his thumb on his right ear and his index finger on his eye. And he recited the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Verily Allah is all hearer, all seer. وَهَذَا إِثْبَاتٌ لِلسَّمْعِ وَالْبَصَرِ بِالْقَوْلِ وَالْفِعْلِ. Prophet ﷺ here confirming Allah's hearing and seeing via statements and actions, proving that Allah Azza wa Jal hears like you hear and He sees like you see. With the fundamental understanding of لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِي شَيْءٍ, there's nothing like unto Him. And if anyone has a problem with this, and then they want to criticize the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I will say to you, hold on to it until Yawm al-Qiyamah, barakallahu feek. If you have an issue with that, and you want to accuse also the Messenger of Allah alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam of anthropomorphism, then save it until Yawm al-Qiyamah and complain to Allah that you were not satisfied with the Messenger that He sent. Because it is not up to you. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَن يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. It is not for a believing man or a believing woman, after Allah and His Messenger have decided upon a matter, that you should have a choice regarding it. You don't really have a choice. That's what submission means. That's what آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ means. Now, we're not here to confront and oppose the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Watch out, ya akhwan wa akhawat. وحينئذ نقول إن إثبات الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام للصفات يكون بالفعل ويكون بالقول ويكون بالفعل مجتمعين ومنفردين. So therefore we say the Prophet's صلى الله عليه وسلم's confirmation to the attributes of Allah can be either in statements or in action, and sometimes they could be together and sometimes they could be separated. Sometimes they are together and sometimes they are separated. أما الإقرار, as for the last one, which is the approval, فهو قليل بالنسبة لما قبله. It is fewer in numbers, in terms of incidents, versus the previous two, the former, which is statements and actions. مثل إقراره الجارية التي سألها أين الله؟ قالت في السماء فأقرها وقال أعتقها. لحديث صحيح مسلم, when the Prophet ﷺ asked, such as his acknowledgement of the slave girl, he asked her, where is Allah? She said, He's above the heavens. Prophet ﷺ acknowledged that and said to Muawiyah, let her free, emancipate her. So now you have one time Prophet ﷺ looking at the sky saying, oh Allah, bear witness. You have another time asking a slave girl, where's Allah? She pointed to the heavens and said, fis sama, above the heavens. Prophet ﷺ said, أَعْتِقَ فَإِنَّ مُؤْمِنًا. And after all of these, people still want to reject that Allah Azza wa Jal is above His creation, and they still want to claim that you cannot say that Allah is above His creation, which is really an outstanding matter, the least to say. وَكَإِقْرَارِهِ الْحَبْرِ مِنَ الْيَهُودِ. And we also have the incident where the Prophet ﷺ acknowledged one of the rabbis of the Jews, الذي جاء وقال للرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام, the one who came and said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, إننا نجد أن الله يجعل السماوات على إصبع. He came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, verily we find basically in our teachings that Allah will place the heavens on one finger, والأرضين على إصبع, and He will place the earth on one finger. والثرى على إصبع إلى آخر الحديث, and so on and so forth on a finger. فضحك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تصديقا لقوله وهذا إقرار. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم laughed or smiled, acknowledging the statement of that rabbi, and that is a form of acknowledgement from the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. تمام. So this is again clear cut of the Prophet ﷺ acknowledging what the rabbi said, that Allah Azza wa Jal will place the heavens on a finger, the earth on a finger, the soil, etc., on a finger, until the end of the hadith. So again, all of these, most Muslims, I would say sadly, are Bismillah, are ignorant of, ya akhwan. Most Muslims have never come across these narrations ever. Nor do they bother nor do their scholars allow them to even read them. Their scholars don't want them to come across this information, because any Muslim with a sound mind and a natural disposition, sound disposition, will understand what is intended and will submit to Allah. But they wanted to avoid one calamity, so they fell into a greater calamity. Wallahu al-musta'an. إذا قال قائل ما وجه وجوب الإيمان بما وصف الرسول به ربه أو ما دليله. If someone were to ask, what is the evidence? What is the evidence? How is it obligatory? Why is it obligatory that we must believe in what the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam described his Lord with? I mean, what's your evidence that this is obligatory on us? What if it weren't? نقول دليله قوله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله والكتاب الذي نزل على رسوله والكتاب الذي أنزل من قبل. We will say to them, as Allah says in Surah An-Nisa, O you who have believed, believe in Allah and His Messenger and the book which He has sent down to His Messenger and the scripture which He sent down to those before Him. وكل آية فيها ذكر فيها ذكر أن الرسول أن الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام مبلغ فهي دالة على وجوب قبول ما أخبر به من صفات الله. Every ayah in the book of Allah that mentions that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is the one who conveys, is a conveyor, is an evidence about the obligation of accepting what he said about the attributes of Allah. لأنه أخبر بها وبلغها إلى الناس, because he spoke about it and he conveyed it to the people. وكلما أخبر به فهو تبليغ من الله. And everything that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke about is actually a means of conveyance from Allah. ولأن الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام أعلم الناس بالله, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is the most knowledgeable of people of Allah. وَأَنصَحُ النَّاسِ لِعِبَادِ اللَّهِ, and he is the most sincere among the people regarding among the slaves of Allah. He is the most sincere, صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَأَصْدَقُ النَّاسِ فِي مَقَالٍ, and he is the most truthful in what he says. وَأَفْصَحُ النَّاسِ فِي التَّعْبِيرِ, and he is the most eloquent of people in expressing himself. فاجتمع في حقه من صفات القبول أربعة. So there are four fundamental qualities that are found in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم regarding the concept of accepting what he said. العلم, knowledge, النصح, the sincere advice, الصدق, truthfulness, والبيان, and the ability to convey and express eloquently, the articulation. فيجب علينا أن نقبل كل ما أخبر به عن ربه. So we are obliged to accept everything that he told us about his Lord. وهو الله, and it, that is Allah. أفصح وأنصح وأعلم من أولئك القوم الذين تبعهم هؤلاء من المناطق والفلاسفة. And he is, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is more eloquent and more sincere and more knowledgeable than those scholars that they have, those people have followed from among the people of philosophy and the various ideologies. You understand? So if you have to select, if you have to select a source to learn about Allah, do you take it from Jahm ibn Safwan, or do you take it from one of these Ash'ari mashayikh, or Mu'tazili mashayikh, or the Maturidi mashayikh, or do you take it from the Messenger of Allah? Who knows better about Allah? The Messenger of Allah. Are they more eloquent? Are they more knowledgeable? Are they more sincere? Yani, what qualities do they have if you compare to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? Are they more truthful? Ultimately not. Faya jama'a, yani, it's wallahi common sense that you take the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Wa ma hadha yaqul subhanak la uhsi thana'an alayka anta kama athnayta 'ala nafsik. In spite of all that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam would still say, how perfect you are. I cannot praise you enough as you have praised yourself. Meaning, in spite of that, Prophet ﷺ was admitting the greatness and majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jalla jalaluhu wa taqaddasat asma'uhu. Tayyib. Qawlihi, and this is important now. من غير تحريف ولا تعطيل ومن غير تكييف ولا تمثيل. Without distortion, nor denial, without the howness, and nor likening. So we don't distort, we don't deny, we don't say how, and we don't liken Allah to His creation. Very important elements to understand, so you will know why Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah believe what they believe. At the same time, they are the farthest people from resembling Allah or making Allah resemble His creation as the deviant people claim we do. They call us al-mujassima, meaning those who give Allah a body. في هذه الشرح في هذه الجملة بيان صفة إيمان أهل السنة بصفات الله تعالى. So in this sentence is the explanation. In this sentence, there's the explanation of the quality of the iman, the belief of Ahl Sunnah in regards to the attributes of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. فأهل السنة والجماعة يؤمنون بها إيمانا خاليا من هذه الأمور الأربعة. أهل السنة والجماعة then believe a perfect belief that is free from these four matters: تحريف, تعطيل, تكييف, تمثيل. And I wish you would memorize them, brothers and sisters, because those are important words. And when you hear takif, mind you that in modern day language, takif means air conditioning. That's why they call it mukayif, because it conditions. So it's the condition of something or the how of something. If you hear that word in a local AC store, don't freak out and think that he's trying to teach you Aqeedah class. Huh? Takif in this context as a linguistic word, it has multiple, actually all of them. Tamthil means acting. So if you say the word tamthil today, the first thing that comes to mind is acting, as in movies. You understand? Ta'til means when you break a car. A car no longer is functioning and no longer moving. All of these words linguistically have modern meanings. In the context of Aqeedah, they have those specific legislative meanings that we are obviously going to discuss and address, inshallah, one by one. I hope that is clear. Tamam. طيب. فالتحريف التغيير وهو إما لفظي أو معنوي. تحريف means linguistically means to change. And that can be by expression, the actual words, or it could be by meaning. There are two ways for you to do tahrif. So there are two ways for you to change what is intended. Either you change the word itself, the terminology, or you change the meaning that that terminology carries. And we will see what that means specifically. وَالْغَالِبْ أَنَّ التَّحْرِيفَ اللَّفْظِيَ لَا يَقَعْ. It is very unlikely or uncommon that distortion or a change to the text takes place. وَإِذَا وَقَعْ فَإِنَّمَا يَقَعُ مِنْ جَهْلٍ. And if it ever takes place, it usually happens by someone who's ignorant. فَالتَّحْرِيفُ اللَّفْظِيَ يَعْنِي تَغْيِيرِ الشَّكْلِ. So the linguistic, the expression, the changing the term, the changing of the term, means changing the form, the apparent form. فَمَثَلًا فَمَا تَجِدْ أَحَدْ يَقُولُ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ بِفَتْحِ الدَّالِ إِلَّا إِذَا كَانَ جَاهِلًا. So whoever says الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ instead of الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, except an ignorant person. And so that is usually what happens. Someone will do a tahrif. Now this person is not intending to change the book of Allah, but he actually fell into a form of tahrim lafzi. You understand? Where he changed the actual word. The expression was changed. I hope that is clear. لكن التحريف المعنوي هو الذي وقع فيه كثير من الناس. As for the distortion of the meaning, then this is the one that many people have fallen into. The one that many people have fallen into is the meaning, the distortion and the changing of the meaning. فأهل السنة والجماعة إيمانهم بما وصف الله به نفسه خال من التحريف يعني تغيير اللفظ أو المعنى. We will elaborate later, inshallah. So Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, their iman is what Allah described Himself with, without any distortion, i.e. change, be it of the words or the expression that is, or nor the meaning, neither one. وَتَغْيِيرُ الْمَعْنَى يُسَمِّيهِ الْقَائِلُونَ بِهِ تَأْوِيلًا. Now here's where it gets really technical, so pay attention. The change or the distortion of the meaning is what those who do this call ta'wil, interpretation. وَيُسَمُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ بِأَهْلِ التَّأْوِيلِ. And they call themselves the people of interpretation. لِأَجْلْ أَنْ يَصْبِغُوا هَذَا الْكَلَامِ صِبْغَةَ الْقَبُولِ. And they do this so that they can dye this statement with the dye of acceptance. Yani, dye here means when you're changing something so that it becomes agreeable to you. Huh? Because if they call themselves نَحْنُ أَهْلُ التَّحْرِيفِ, we are the people of distortion, who's going to take them seriously? Who's going to take them seriously? We are the people of distortion. Oh, mashallah, tabarakallah. Yes, brother, I'm specialized and I have a PhD in distorting the book of Allah. By the way, they will have fans. You'll have some Muslims, mashallah, Sheikh, wallah, I love you more than my mother and father and uncle in the whole world, ya Sheikh. Ya Sheikh, may Allah increase you in goodness. You are the, I love distortion. Distortion is the way to go, Sheikh. Keep them coming. Keep them coming, Sheikh. Mocking and sarcasm are not allowed unless you're the one using it. It's only halal for the doer, haram upon everyone else. It's okay to say that you are cosigned to the dustbin of history and that you're nothing but a neophyte with an IQ less than two digits. No, this is halal, 100%, no mockery, no sarcasm. But when you do it, ya Sheikh, attaqillah ya Sheikh, la yajuz. لا يجوز ولا لا عصير, as the brother said in the highlights of the football. المهم, let's not get distracted because this is a distracting topic. So they cannot call themselves, we are the people of distortion. What do they say? We are the people of interpretation. We are the people of interpretation, and they're doing this so that you can, that statement can become agreeable to you. لأن التأويل لا تنفر منه النفوس ولا تكره. Because if you say we are the people of interpretation, that's not something that the people detest or hate. لكن ما ذهبوا إليه في الحقيقة تحريف. However, what they're actually doing is not interpretation, it is distortion. لأنه ليس عليه دليل صحيح, because there isn't a clear-cut evidence for it. There isn't an authentic sound evidence to support it. إلا أنهم لا يستطيعون أن يقولوا تحريفا ولو قالوا هذا تحريف لأعلنوا على أنفسهم برفض كلامهم. So they cannot call it تحريف. If they called it, this is a distortion, then the people will, they would have announced against themselves a reason for the people to reject their statements. So I hope that's clear. ولهذا عبر المؤلف رحمه الله بالتحريف دون التأويل مع أن كثيرا ممن يتكلمون في هذا الباب يعبرون بنفي التأويل. That's why the Shaykh رحمه الله used the term تحريف, distortion, and not interpretation, even though a lot of the people that discuss this matter in that chapter, they will speak about the denying the ta'wil. Denying the ta'wil. يقولون من غير ta'wil, لكن ما عبر به المؤلف أولى لوجوه أربعة. So they say, يعني some other authors of Aqeedah, instead of saying من غير تحريف, they say من غير ta'wil. The Shaykh said, it is better to say من غير تحريف instead of ta'wil. It's better to say without distortion rather than without interpretation for four reasons. الوجه الأول, أنه اللفظ الذي جاء به القرآن. First of all, the four reasons why we stick to the word tahrif. The first of which is that this is the term that the Quran brought. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى قَالْ يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَنْ مَوَضِعِهِ. Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, here are some who displace words from their right places. So a form of displacement or changing or distortion. وَالتَّعْبِيرُ الَّذِي عَبَّرَ بِهِ الْقُرْآنَ أَوْلَى مِنْ غَيْرِهِ لَأَنَّهُ أَدَلْ عَلْ مَعْنَى. So the expression that the Quran chooses is better and superior to anything other than that because it is closer to the intended meaning. الْوَجْهُ الثَّانِي, the second reason. أَنَّهُ أَدَلْ عَلَى الْحَالُ وَأَقْرَبْ إِلَى الْعَدْلِ. It is more specific and accurate about the reality and it is closer to justice. فالمؤول بغير دليل ليس من العدل أن نسميه مؤولا. Anyone who's interpreting without an evidence, we can't really call him an interpreter. بل العدل أن نصفه بما يستحق وهو أن يكون محرفا. Rather, it is more just that we describe him with what he deserves, and that is that he is distorting the meaning. الوجه الثالث, the third, أن التأويل بغير دليل باطل. interpretation without evidence is false. يَجِبُ الْبُعْدَ عَنْهُ وَالتَّنْفِيرُ مِنْهُ. You must stay away from it, and you must scare the people away from it as well. وَاسْتِعْمَالُ التَّحْرِيفِ فِيهِ أَبْلَغْ تَنْفِيرًا مِنَ التَّأْوِيلِ. And so using the term tahrif is actually more likely to deter the people from entering that area than using the term merely, the mere term interpretation. لِأَنَّ التَّحْرِيفَ لَا يَقْبَلُ أَحَدٍ. Because distortion, the word itself, no one will accept. When you tell the Christians your books are distorted, it's an insult. If you tell someone, I'm going to do a distortion of the book of Allah, nobody's going to take you seriously. If you say, I'm going to interpret the book of Allah, well, okay, that sounds good. What do you have to say? أما التحريف بمجرد ما نقول هذا تحريف ينفر الإنسان منه. So as for distortion, as soon as you say the word, the people will run away from it. وإذا كان كذلك, if this is so, فإن استعمال التحريف في من خالف طريق السلف أليق من استعمال التأويل. So then using the term تحريف regarding those who oppose the way of the Salaf is more suitable than using the term interpretation. الوجه الرابع أن التأويل ليس مذموما كله. Interpretation is not fully condemned. It's not fully something that is condemned. Not every type of interpretation is evil. قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام اللهم فقهه في الدين وعلمه التأويل. The Prophet ﷺ said, and I believe this was regarding Ibn Abbas. He said, Oh Allah, give him understanding of the religion and teach him interpretation. وقال الله تعالى وما يعلم تأويله إلا الله. والراسخون في العلم. Allah عز وجل says, but no one knows the ta'wil save Allah and those who are firmly grounded in knowledge. فامتدحهم بأنهم يعلمون التأويل. So Allah praised them for knowing interpretation. So here the term interpretation means to understand the meaning behind the Quran, not to give it a new meaning. والتأويل ليس كله مذموما لأن التأويل له معاني متعددة. So the term ta'wil is a more generic, comprehensive and general term. And it has many variable meanings. يكون بمعنى التفسير. It could mean exegesis. It could mean to explain. ويكون بمعنى العاقبة والمآل. It could mean also the outcome of something, the end result of something. ويكون بمعنى صرف اللفظ عن ظاهره. And it could also mean to give a variant meaning than what is apparent. So all of these fall under the term ta'wil. So if you say without ta'wil, actually you might have an issue because some of the valid usages of ta'wil are being compromised. Therefore, the most accurate description for what these people of dalal are doing is to call it bila tahrif, that Ahl-us-Sunnah don't do tahrif, distortion, and not merely ta'wil. ويكون معنى بمعنى التفسير كقول كثير من المفسرين عندما يفسرون الآية يقولون تأويل قوله تعالى كذا وكذا. And also it could mean the, like I said earlier, the exegesis. That's why a lot of the people, the scholars of tafsir, when they're interpreting an ayah, they say, and the interpretation or the meaning is of this, of the statement of Allah, such is such and such. ثُمَّ يَذْكُرُونَ الْمَعْنَى. Then they will mention the actual meaning. وَسُمِّيَ التَّفْسِيرُ تَأْوِيلًا. And so the science of exegesis is also called ta'wil. لِأَنَّنَا أَوَّلْنَا الْكَلَامِ أَيْ جَعَلْنَاهُ يَأُولُ إِلَى مَعْنَاهِ الْمُرَادِ بِهِ. Because we explained it, as in we allowed it or we delivered it to the intended meaning that it was revealed with. We delivered it to that intended meaning at the end. أي طيب تأويل بمعنى عاقبة الشيء. وأي ونعم, the Shaykh has given examples of all the usages of تأويل. تأويل بمعنى عاقبة الشيء. And also تأويل can be with the meaning of the outcome of something. وهذا إن ورد في طلب فتأويله فعله إنه كان أمرا وتركه إن كان أمرا وتركه إن كان نهيا وإن ورد في خبر فتأويله ووقوعه. So when you hear the تأويل, if it's a command, you do it if it's a command, you stay away from it if it's a prohibition, and if it comes in the form of information, then the ta'wil of that is that thing taking place and materializing. That thing taking place and materializing. مثال, the Shaykh will give examples. مثاله في الخبر قولي تعالى هل ينظرون إلا تأويله يوم يأتي تأويله يقول الذين نسوه من قبل قد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق. Await they just for the final fulfillment of the event? on the day the event is finally fulfilled, i.e. the day of resurrection, those who neglected it before will say, verily the messengers of our Lord did come with the truth. فالمعنى ما ينتظر هؤلاء إلا عاقبتي وما آلي ما أخبر به. So those people are only waiting for the outcome and the end result of what they have been informed with. يوم يأتي ذلك المخبر به. When that which has been told to come about will come about. يقول الذين نسوه من قبل قد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق. Those who have forgotten about it, they will say, oh, the messengers of our Lord have come with the truth. ومنه قول يوسف لما خر له أبواه وإخوته سجدا. And also the statement of Yusuf when his father and his brothers fell down in prostration to him. قال هذا تأويل رؤياي من قبل. He said, this is the interpretation of my dream aforetime. هذا وقوع رؤياي. This is the materialization of my dream. لأنه قال ذلك بعد أن سجدوا له. He said that after they prostrated to him. And as you know, the prostration was part of the shara' of the people at the time of Yusuf, and it is not from the shara' of the Muhammad alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, no one is allowed to prostrate to anyone. That prostration was not that of worship, it was that of respect. And even that in the Ummah and the Sharia of the Prophet alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was removed. Even the prostration of respect was removed. And you no longer show respect to anybody like that. That belongs strictly to Allah Jalla Jalaluhu wa taqaddasat asma'uhu. ومثاله في الطلب قول عائشة رضي الله عنها كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يكثر أن يقول في ركوعه وسجوده بعد أن أنزل عليه قوله تعالى إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح يكثر أن يقول في ركوعه وسجوده سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك اللهم اغفر لي يتأول القرآن. And also an example of the request is the statement of Aisha that the Prophet ﷺ would abundantly say in his prostration and his bowing and his prostration after Allah revealed the ayah upon him, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ, when comes the help of Allah and the conquest, the Prophet ﷺ would often say in his bowing and prostration, سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ رَبَّنَا وَبِحَمْدِكَ, how perfect you are, our Lord, and praise be to you. اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي, O Allah, forgive me. يَتَأَوَّلَ الْقُرْآنَ, meaning acting upon the Qur'an. Acting upon the Qur'an. المعنى الثالث التأويل, the third type meaning of the word تأويل, صرف اللفظ عن ظاهره, changing the expression from the apparent. وهذا النوع ينقسم إلى محمود ومذموم. This type is divided into two types, praiseworthy and blameworthy. فإن دل عليه دليل فهو محمود. If you have an evidence that tells you to understand it differently than what the obvious and apparent is, it is praiseworthy. وَيَكُونُ مِنَ الْقِسْمِ الْأَوَّلِ, and that falls under the first type of ta'wil, which is tafsir. It's a form of exegesis and explanation. وَأَنْ لَمْ يَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ دَلِيلٍ, however, if there's no evidence that supports it, فَهُوَ مَذْمُومٌ. Please understand, this is very important. Then it becomes blameworthy. وَيَكُونُ مِنْ بَابِ التَّحْرِيفِ, it falls under the area of false interpretation and distortion. وليس من باب التأويل, and it is not merely interpretation. وهذا الثاني هو الذي درج عليه أهل التحريف في صفات الله عز وجل. And that second type, the one that has no evidence to support it, is the one that all these people of distortion have fallen into in regards to the attributes of Allah, the exalted, the sublime. مثاله قوله تعالى الحمد لله يا أخوان. الحمد لله, we came. An example is the statement of Allah, الرحمن على العرش استوى, the most merciful rose over the throne. Surah Taha, ayah number 5. ظاهر اللفظ أن الله تعالى استوى على العرش. The apparent meaning of the ayah is that Allah عز وجل ascended over the throne. استقر عليه, settled above it. وعلى عليه, and he is exalted above it. فإذا قال قائل معنى استوى استولى, if one were to say the meaning of استوى is استولى, to overcome, to overtake, to overcome or to overtake, to acquire something that was once not yours. نقول هذا تأويل عندك, we say this is an interpretation according to you. لأنك صرفت اللفظ عن ظاهره, you have changed the apparent meaning. لكن هذا تحريف في الحقيقة. That's not تأويل. That's not you just give an interpretation. You're actually distorting and changing the meaning. لأنه ما دل عليه دليل. Because you have no evidence to support it. بل الدليل على خلافه. Rather, the evidence is against that. Against what you're saying, meaning that evidence of istawla that you've added, you've changed the meaning, we have evidence to negate it, as we will see later on, inshallah ta'ala. It's very important. فَأَمَّا قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى أَتَى أَمْرُ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَسْتَعْجِلُوا. As for the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, the event ordained by Allah will come to pass, so seek not to hasten it. فَمَعْنَا أَتَى أَمْرُ اللَّهِ أَيْ سَيَأْتِي أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. The meaning of that is that the command of Allah, the matter which Allah ordained, shall come to pass. هَذَا مُخَالِفٌ لِظَاهِرِ اللَّفْظِ. And this is, goes against the apparent meaning of the text. لَكِنْ عَلَيْهِ دَلِيلٌ. But we have an evidence for that, because ata is in the past. And we're talking about, we're saying it means it will come. So the verb, the tense used is ata, it came, but we're saying that means it shall come. Huh. What is, but why did we do this interpretation? Do we have an evidence or we don't? We have an evidence. Where's the evidence? It's the same ayah. فَلَا تَسْتَعْجِلُوا. Then do not be hasten. If it already came in the past, how can we be hastening towards something that already happened? So the same ayah gives you the proper interpretation in the beginning of the ayah. You understand? So when there's an evidence for understanding something other than the apparent meaning for a reason, there has to be a reason first why you're understanding differently, and then you have to have an evidence that supports it. If so, no issue. If there's no evidence, it becomes a blameworthy. وكذلك قوله تعالى فإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And similarly, the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, so when you recite the Quran, seek refuge with Allah from Shaytan, the outcast. أي إذا أردت أن تقرأ وليس المعنى إذا أكملت القراءة. So that means if you want to recite, and the intended meaning is not if you've completed reciting. قل أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Say, I seek refuge with Allah from the accursed shaitan. لأننا علمنا من السنة أن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام إذا أراد أن يقرأ استعاذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Because we know from the sunnah that when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wanted to recite the Quran, he would say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لا إذا أكمل القراءة. Not when he completes the recitation. So the reason why now, the ayah, if you understand the Arabic language, it could mean that once you've completed, seek refuge in Allah. Why are we doing ta'wil to mean that not if you have completed, rather before? Because we have an evidence from the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ how he practiced it. So now we're doing a ta'wil, which is a legitimate ta'wil. It's a legitimate interpretation because of an evidence that supports it. فالتأويل صحيح. So this type of interpretation is valid. وكذلك قول أنس بن مالك كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل الخلاء قال أعوذ بالله من الخبث والخبائث. Similarly, when the Prophet ﷺ entered the area in which he would relieve himself, he would say, I seek refuge in Allah from al-khubuth and al-khabaith, which is basically all types of evil and filth and the shayateen. فمعنى إذا دخل إذا أراد أن يدخل. إذا دخل meaning if he entered actually means if he wanted to enter. Again, this whole discussion, يا أخوان أخوات, is about the tenses, the verbal tenses. We're talking about the verbal tenses because the word says إذا دخل, if he entered. So you will understand from the apparent meaning that you do this after you enter. However, we understand that إذا دخل means if he wanted to enter. لأن ذكر الله لا يليق داخل هذا المكان. Because mentioning Allah عز وجل is not suitable inside the washroom. فلهذا حملنا قوله إذا دخل على إذا أراد أن يدخل. So we understand if he wanted to enter. That's how we interpret it. هذا التأويل الذي دل عليه الدليل صحيح ولا يعدو أن يكون تفسيرا. This is then the interpretation that is supported by sound evidence. And the most we can call it is just a form of valid interpretation. لذلك قلنا إن التعبير بالتحريف عن التأويل الذي ليس عليه دليل صحيح أولى. That's why we said, using the term تحريف rather than ta'wil that has no valid evidence for doing so is more befitting. لِأَنَّهُ الَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ الْقُرْآنِ, because that's what the Qur'an used, يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَةِ عَمَّ وَضِعِهِ. Allah used the term يُحَرِّفُونَ, تَحْرِيف. وَلِأَنَّهُ أَلْسَقْ بِطَرِيقٍ مُحَرِّفٍ, and because it is closer to the methodology of the distorter. وَلِأَنَّهُ أَشَدُّ تَنْفِيرًا عَنْ هَذِهِ الطَّرِيقَ الْمُخَالِفَةِ لِطَرِيقِ السَّلَفِ, because it is a stronger deterrent for those who oppose the way of the Salaf. وَلِأَنَّ التَّحْرِيفَ كُلُّهُ مَذْمُومٌ, كُلُّهُ مَذْمُومٌ, because كُلُّهُ مَذْمُومٌ, all type of distortion is blameworthy. بخلاف التأويل, unlike interpretation, فَإِنَّ مِنْهُ مَا يَكُونُ مَذْمُومًا وَمَحْمُودًا. There are types of it that are blameworthy and others that are praiseworthy. فَيَكُونُ التَّعْبِيرُ بِالتَّحْرِيفِ أَوْلَى من التعبير بالتأويل من أربعة أوجه. So then, using the term, that Ahl Sunnah Jama'a do not do tahrif is more befitting than using they don't do ta'wil for the four reasons that were mentioned previously. So we will conclude with this inshallah, and بإذن الله عز وجل, if we remain alive and healthy till next Friday, we will be dealing with the continuation about the ta'til and the takif and the tamthil and whatever Allah Azza wa Jal facilitates. Let me see if you brothers have any questions that we need to entertain right now and address. Okay, here we go. I thank Allah for allowing me to hear your lectures and this book in audio form many years ago. Barakallah feek. They have benefited me much and other lectures as well. I ask Allah to keep you and keep a righty guide on the straight path. Akhi Zakallah khair. Barakallah feek. What is the meaning of Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen? Watch my lecture, One Way to Paradise. I have a lecture titled One Way to Paradise, even though that's my channel name and my Facebook page name. The lecture is actually explaining Surah Al-Fatiha, and basically, all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds, Alameen from Alam, or a flag, or any sign. So anything that is a sign of Allah's existence that encompasses everything that Allah created, Allah is the Lord and Master of all of that which He created, all of the worlds, in other words. And Allah deserves to be praised, not only thanked, because He has the qualities that deserve to be praised. Usually you thank someone when they do you a favor. Allah Azza wa Jal, even if He did nothing for you, which He did plenty, He has the beautiful names and attributes that make Him worthy of praise. Oh, alhamdulillah, nothing, that doesn't mean anything. It's just a mispronunciation. It's a distortion. Yes, it was mentioned, meaning somebody by mistake who hasn't memorized the Quran, instead of, you know, you hear this a lot when some random person leads the salah, you see them, they butcher the recitation. So it's basically someone that basically did not pronounce it properly. There's no other meaning behind it. Is it okay if a sister wants to marry a student of knowledge? Subhanallah, why? Are students of knowledge not allowed to get married? What do you mean, is it okay? Sister Fatima, please elaborate. That's a very concerning question. Why would it not be okay for a sister to marry a student of knowledge? Are they not supposed to be married? Are they supposed to be, you know, single all their life just studying? Of course, it's okay. Actually, it's great. If she finds a decent student of knowledge who's gonna, you know, teach her the deen, teach her children the deen, it's a big blessing from Allah. Like, is it okay to choose only a student of knowledge? I mean, it's up to the sister's standards. If she only wants a student of knowledge, alhamdulillah, but what if she doesn't come across one? I mean, she also has to be realistic. If you have a pool of students of knowledge from which you can choose easily, and it can happen, alhamdulillah. If that's not the case, you will be single for the rest of your life. That's not exactly how it's supposed to be. It is ideal that you, if you can find a decent student of knowledge, may Allah bless and facilitate. But if not, don't close the door of marriage completely. Type, can Christians say the same thing about the Trinity? Can they say that we affirm the meaning of one in three, but we do not describe how? That's a very good question. No, they cannot. And the reason why, just have a basic conversation with any Christian. Have a basic conversation with any Christian. What are we saying here? We're saying we believe in what Allah described Himself with. Their book, did Allah Azza wa Jal describe Himself with Trinity? Do you understand the difference? We are referring to the Quran. We have first the foundation of the Quran being a preserved revelation from Allah. Upon that, we are trying to understand Allah as He described Himself with. If they're going to say this about the Bible, then before we even go into the subject matter, which Bible? And where does God describe or mentions even the word Trinity in the entire Bible? You will not find Trinity once. Yani, so there's no foundation for Trinity to begin with. The Christians have formulated this concept, which is not divinely inspired. If it were divinely inspired, we will say no problem. If Allah wanted Trinity to be, then we would believe what Allah wants. But theirs is not divinely inspired and ours is. Big difference, ya Ahmad. Assalamu alaikum. Sometimes we hear the term tamthil and tashbih being used interchangeably. How should we understand their meaning? Can you give some examples, inshallah? I could, but then that would be a spoiler for what's coming. Because when we discuss the matter of tamthil, we will be speaking about tashbih. And so there's a very technical difference between them, but the Shaykh will explain it with information, with details, with examples. So I would rather, if I explain it now, then I have to explain it again in the book. Ma'alesh, be patient, inshallah. We will come across this very soon, and it will be very clear to you, bi'idhnillah. Yeah, so we can entertain other questions that may be irrelevant. I don't mean to disappoint you, Allah, but I know you will understand. Is it true that Imam Nawawi and Ibn Hajar were Ash'aris? No. It is true that they both had some misunderstandings and some stances that they took that were in agreement with the Ash'ari Aqeedah, but that does not mean that we call them full-fledged Ash'aris. And if so, even so, let's say they had some Ash'ari tendencies, we still say their matter is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those were scholars who were at a level where they were doing some form of interpretation and they went against the bulk of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah. And so, even if they were to be erroneous, as we know the Prophet ﷺ said, then the alim, when he makes an ijtihad, even if he gets it wrong, Allah Azza wa Jal will reward him. But for Jarjur down the street, who wants to follow some other sheikh, who doesn't have any qualification to be falling into this error, opposing the Messenger of Allah, accepting the statement of someone else, he doesn't have that same privilege that they did. Does the sheikh go over the statement? What happened? Of the Sahaba and their students, does he go over statements from Ikrima, Abu Ali, you will see, brother, you will see. MashaAllah, everybody's excited about the, shall I do the whole book in one day? We will come. Everything will come, inshallah. And look, if you're really in a rush, I've already gone over this book in audio. So you can go to the website, onewaytoparadise.net, and you could listen to the audio. It's there in MP3 format. You will see what has been discussed and addressed already. This is off topic, so please ignore this. It's not the right time. I'm over the age limit for applying for the Islamic University of Medina. I'm 26 and from Australia. Do you know someone who can help me get in? Wallahi, yeah, brother, unfortunately, I don't. I don't, Habibi. May Allah make it easy for you. But don't restrict yourself to, first of all, they do make exceptions. Second of all, don't restrict yourself to Medina University. There are other options. There's the Imam, Jami'at al-Imam in Riyadh. There's Umm al-Qura in Mecca. Yani, broaden your horizon. Keep your options more. Should Muslim who live in the Western country homeschool their kids or take them to public school? Homeschool. Ya Sheikha, we live in the kingdom and we homeschool our children. We homeschool our children. We haven't sent them to school. Let alone in the West, especially now with the LGBTQ, Allah al-Musta'an, they're going to bring a homosexual teacher to read books for them about gay marriage. I mean, that's what's next. America! Tayyib, some people misinterpret... Wait, did I miss something? Hey, there are people who say... وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ means Allah is everywhere. Could you please clarify the matter? SubhanAllah, it says that the footstool, the chair, which is the footstool, has encompassed the heavens and the earth. What does that have to do with Allah being everywhere? We know, look, Allah created the creation and He is separate from His creation. That's what you need to understand. You know all the creation of all the heavens and the earth? Allah is separated from them. Allah is not in His creation. Allah, the throne is the highest of the creation, and Allah is above the throne in a manner which befits His majesty. He does not mix with this creation. And therefore, how can they say that Allah is everywhere because of this ayah? And then we say, even if they say this, okay, barakallah feek, this ayah is mutashabih. This falls under the ambiguous ayat. Allah tells us that one day is a mutashabih and muhkam, you have to refer to the muhkam. Then how do you deal with all the ayat where Allah Azza wa Jalla, amintum man fi sama an yakhsifa bikum al-ard? Or Fir'aun saying to Musa, Haman, ibni li sarhan la'alli ablughu al-asbab, create for me a tower so I can climb and ascend. فَأَطَّلِعَ إِلَىٰ إِلَٰهِ مُوسَىٰ, so I can look at Moses' God. What are you doing with these clear-cut ayat that Allah Azza wa Jalla is above? عَجِيبٌ أَنْتُمْ أَيُّهَا الشَّعَبَّ. طيب, tick, 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 yeah, tick, tick, tick. Some people misinterpret the verses speaking about the attributes of Allah and tell the Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah commit shirk by interpret them directly. Can you please explain? You gotta listen to the book from the beginning and continue with us till the end. I mean, that's what this whole book is about. It's to refute those who make the claim that we are, you know, describing Allah in a manner that doesn't befit Him, when they are describing Allah in a manner which does not befit Him. But you know, the difference between us, ya akhi, is that everything we say is based on the Quran and the Sunnah. And everything they say is based on their mukh, mafi. Can you please clarify the tawheed, al-ma'na of attributes like yad ustad? Yeah, brother, all of these are coming in the book. We've already discussed this in the previous session, the bal yadahu mabsutatan, rather both of His hands are stretched out. Allah Azza wa Jal has hands, two hands, and they're both right, as the Prophet said, wa kilta yadayhi yameen, both of His hands are right, and those hands are nothing like His creation. We affirm what Allah described Himself with. We don't deny and distort the meaning. We're exactly what we're warning against. Bila tahrif, no distortion of the meaning. Yad means power. Allah could have used quwwa. Allah could have used power if Allah wanted to use power. Allah used hands. Just accept what Allah used. Are you more eloquent than Allah? Ish hadha, not you, of course. Those people I'm saying. What does it mean the curse of is the place? The curse is the place of the 2 feet, as I think Ibn Abbas and another Sahabi affirmed. Kursi, brother, it's coming in the book. All of these topics are coming in the same book we're covering. So patience, ya akhwan, as-sabr, as-sabr, as-sabr al-jameel. And then you will all understand. The same thing, ya Ahmed, you're asking all these questions. I don't know, this Ahmed is starting to look like a funny guy, Ahmed. Ahmed, the harwala is coming. All of these are coming in the book. I'm not going to explain the book in a Q&A session. Yalla, that's enough. Suggestion, albeit a possible controversial, what do you think of changing a YouTube channel name to your actual name? It might make it easier to find your content. Very good point. We have considered that in the past, but One Way to Paradise has gone a long way, akhi. It's been many, many years. And usually when you type my name on YouTube, you get One Way to Paradise. So with the algorithm of YouTube and the search, it's all the same, inshallah. Akhiya Khats, saying how or why it's an innovation. Akhiya Khats? What is Akhiya Khats, man? I don't know what that is. How to advise old friends to turn back and become practice Muslims? By you being knowledgeable enough to advise them. There isn't one standardized advice. You have to assess that person's religious commitment, his problems, what kind of advice they need. I mean, it's honestly, it's a broad topic. I have a lecture on this titled Nasiha, take it or take it. Go on YouTube, type take it or take it, and then you will watch a lecture about how to give Nasiha to people. And I give a lot of Nasayih there also. Are we allowed to pray in the masjid with the gaps in this pandemic? Yes, some of the scholars allowed it. I personally am of the position that I don't. I'm of the position that you don't, because you know, dar'ul mafasid muqaddam ala jalb al masalih. Avoiding harm takes precedence over attaining a benefit. But that's my personal commitment. I don't impose it on anyone. I don't even propagate it. I don't invite anyone to it. Whoever wants to pray in the masjid, may Allah reward them with goodness. Let them pray in the masjid. I personally don't see that you take such risk and you mix and you expose yourself to getting ill, such a serious illness, to pray in the jama'ah. And Allah knows our intentions. Had we been able to go to the masjid, wallahi akhi, we would go. So very simple. طيب اخوان, this will be the last question because we're running out of time. How can I find a teacher? Can you be my teacher? I mean, I'm teaching now. That's as good as it gets. If you consider that to be your teacher, then we're on the same page. One more question. What is the view of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah regarding the attributes of Allah, the same as the Sahaba? Again, ya akhwan, please. All this is what this book is addressing. Akhayikhat, regarding Allah being above the throne, you can't say why or how because it's an innovation. Wallah, I don't understand what's going on, Habibi. But whatever it is, ya akhi or ukhti, it will come in the book. I don't know what this word. Write it in Arabic so I can understand. Can't say why or how. Yeah, we don't say how. Allah, that's one of the things that we don't do. Bila takif, without saying how. Allah is above his throne. How? None of your business how. If Allah wanted you to know, he would have revealed it. You know, that's what you say to anyone. If they say how, say, why are you asking how? The Prophet ﷺ knew, the Sahaba were more keen on learning, they didn't have this conversation, why are we having this conversation? Oh, have you ever thought about doing a comprehensive series of videos on Tawheed starting from books like Qawa'id al-Arba'a and Usul al-Thalatha? I've already covered those books, akhi, on my website in audio format. I haven't thought about the video, or maybe I have, but I'm not there yet. So we'll see what Allah facilitates. But if you're interested in those, Kashfu al-Shubuhat, al-Usul al-Thalatha, it's already on my website, onewaytoparadise.net, in audio format. Well, we are in contact now. So yes, you can contact me, brother, even on my WhatsApp. I'm at your service, inshallah. Okay, with this we conclude. Zakum Allah khair. Barakallahu feekum. Hafizakum Allah. Subhanakallahu bihamdik. Ashadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.